So hi guys, welcome back into my channel. And in today's video, we are going to change the rear brake shoe of my Activa. You can do it with any of the two-wheeler scooters, two-wheeler bikes, and those who have the drum brakes, you can do on that. Those who have disc brakes, they have the different procedure and method. I'll show you in our some next videos. But today we are going to change the rear drum brake. So what we have to do, I'll just tell you in short, that we just need to open the bigger screw situated in middle of the tire. We have to open that, remove the tire, remove the older brake shoes, place the new ones, again place the tire and tighten it. But we have to loose the side spring and wire so that the brake shoe may got release and loose, so that it may be easy for you to take it off. So let's get started. So in order to change the brake shoe, we all know what we have to do. We have to open the wheel. So to open the wheel, we need to open the nut. And this nut is this one. This, as you can see over here, this one, this. So let's open it. We can't open wheel like this only, because if we do that, wheel will try to move. So we have to place something like this, or if you have any metal rod, any steady rod, you can place it right there, right on this side. And it will look like this. This. So okay, now let's open the nut. Open it and take the wheel out. It's a bit tight, so you need to apply the pressure. Now what we have to do is just rotate the wheel. And that nut will come out automatically. Now we have to open this. As you can see, this, we just have to pull it back and open this. In my case, it is very loose and easy, but in case of you, it may be tight, very tight. So you maybe need a plier or wrench, so be careful. It's not that easy always. Okay, as we remove that, now apply a bit pressure and rotate the wheel. And the wheel is out. The wheel is out. Now, as you can see the condition of the brake shoes, see, it has totally gone. So now we have to remove it just by doing like this. One side, another, and out. Okay. You have to remove these springs and see the condition of the brake shoe. It's totally gone. So now we have to replace it with the new ones. I have this. It is a local brand. I'm not using the genuine part. An original one or a new one is look like this. You can see. And now the spring you have removed from the older brake shoes, this you have to apply it here. You have to put it here. Here you go, the set of new brake shoes. But before that, we need to rub this part. As you can see, this part, so much carbon is there. See, so we have to rub this with sandpaper. So let's do it. Here I have a small sandpaper, so we have to take like this and rub it. Now you can see the condition, how it is looking before rubbing and after rubbing. And these are the condition of brake shoes. So now let's again put the brake shoe in its position. So you just need to do like this, fit it, and again do like this. Okay, so let's do it. Have you guys heard that click wali sound? Now it's perfectly in its position. Now we have to again apply the wheel. in its original position. Let's do it. I have just lie down the Activa, tilted it, so that you'll be easily able to see the process, and it will be easy for me too. So we just need to as you can see, I have put the wheel in its position. Here is the washer and the bolt we have to fix. It will go like this. Let's apply it. Again, we have to put that, this time we have to put place this above the in the upper side, not in the lower side. In the while we were opening this, we have placed it in the lower side, but now we are placing it to the upper side. Difference. As you can see, we have placed this rod. Now we have to tighten it. So we have to carefully tighten it. And we have to tighten it very hard, so that while you are driving, it won't slip out. That's a very risky situation, by the way. As I'm using my leg pressure to tighten it up, now I have successfully tied this up. Now again, pick the Activa up. Now, as we removed it earlier, we have to place it again. Just we need to place it here. And we have to pass the spring. Okay. It's the wrong side. We have to place it like this. Again, wrong side. I think it's the right side. Okay, it's the right side. Now we have to tighten this up. This won't go very far, because earlier this brake shoe has rubbed up and gone completely, so it goes till here, till the end, means death. Puri jaan le liya iski main. but it's new, so this will go, I suppose, till there only. Let's see how far it will go in its normal position. I forgot to remove that part. It's too tight. I have to loose it a bit. Now it's all right, I suppose. Let's check the brake lever, how it is. As you can see, it's too loose. So we have to tighten it. But one thing I also forgot to tell you, here used to be a spring which I totally forgot to tell you that few days ago I broke that spring into 4-5 parts. So I forgot to remove that and tell you. So guys, this is the spring which supposed to be there, but I broke it, so I'm placing it right now in front of you guys. Wait for a second. You have to do it while you have to remove this, then you have to pull it back, then you have to apply. I know how to apply it so that I am doing it without any trouble. See, you have to do like this and place it right here. It's done, it's in its place, and now we have to tighten it up. I think it's fairly enough. Let's test it. It's fairly good. It's perfectly normal, but I need some more braking power, so I'll tighten a bit more. And it will be perfect for me. Let's check it again. Perfect for me. Now we have done changing. So yeah guys, that much is in the video. I hope you like the video. If you like it, please make the black thumbs up icon blue, and if you still not subscribed to my channel, make the red subscribe button black. And if you have any queries, please comment down below. Tab tak ke liye.